If you're looking to go more plant-based in your eating habits, and of course we're hearing a lot about that, and you want an alternative to tuna salad that's tasty and good for you, how about tuna salad? This man will explain. Certified health coach and plant-based chef John Van Vlaardingen. Did I say that right?
You said it right.
Okay. Yep. He's here now to show us how to do this and to make a real tasty treat. So it's not tuna, so it's tuna.
Correct. There's no tuna, no fish in this dish, but with the dulce flakes and kind of like the chickpeas, it does give you that sea life flavor.
It gives you the flavor. So, yeah. And the dulce flakes are basically seaweed, right?
They are seaweed, yeah.
Okay, all right. So how do we go about doing this? And why is it important first, before we even get into the steps, to go plant-based?
Well, people, when they come to me with health issues, especially chronic diseases these days, they go to a doctor. The doctor tells them, it's like, okay, you need to eat healthier. Mm-hmm. They don't know where to start. And so if you start with a plant-based, including more fruits, veggies, legumes, and grains into your diet, less fat, and let cholesterol. At that point, you definitely will see an improvement in your health.
But I think a lot of people feel like they're not going to get the protein that they need with plant-based.
I always hear that.
Is that a myth?
It is a myth. You get plenty of protein if you eat your fruits. If you eat the calories that you need, you get all the protein that your body requires.
Plenty of protein in this dish?
Oh, yeah. With the chickpeas and some of the veggies that I use, there's plenty of protein in here.
All right. So how do we put this together? It's pretty easy, huh?
It is pretty easy. Okay. The hardest part is chopping everything up. So I already got that pre-done.
All right.
So what you do is like you get the chickpeas, use your measure it up. Doesn't have to be completely meshed up. You can also use a food processor if you want to. But in this case, I just use the potato masher.
All right.
After you get it done like this, then what you do is just like you use the celery, already kind of like diced up.
And I see you diced it up pretty small, right?
I like that.
Yeah.
It gives you kind of like a nice flavor instead of like chewing big pieces. Okay. And when it looks like that, you want to make sure you have small pieces.
Right. Okay. So you put the celery in and what else?
Then red bell pepper.
All right. That's a nice flavor to it, right?
And a nice color. Otherwise, it's going to be all gray and green.
There you go. And you want to add some red and orange and
just make it look
colors.
Nice.
There you go.
Then I have the red onion.
Okay. You better be, everybody better be eating this if they're going to kiss.
I don't have any garlic today, so that's good. Okay. And then the pickles. I personally like kind of like the French pickles, but you can use also the more sweeter ones. But this has kind of like a sour taste to it.
Whatever your taste preference is. Right?
Exactly.
All right.
Then just a little bit of pepper.
Okay.
And then the dulce seaweed.
All right.
So
now the seaweed, you can pretty much get this anywhere.
Most health food stores have it. If it's not kind of like chopped up in the flakes that I have here, then just kind of like use a coffee grinder.
Right. And just mash it up.
Yep.
Okay.
And then I made my own cashew sour cream. And so pretty easy. Yeah, you soak the cashews overnight. And then what you do is you use some apple cider vinegar, some lemon. I use the apple cider vinegar and lemon. Some people kind of like add some water to it.
Okay.
But I like the sour taste.
So this is in place of the mayo.
And chase in place with the mayo or kind of like your sour cream.
Okay. All right. So you made that. Can we steal that recipe too for the cashew sour cream?
I'll make sure you guys get all the ingredients.
Both of these recipes will be up on our website in a few hours, daytimeonline.tv. So now comes the arm workout, right?
That's all it is.
Yeah. Just mix it up. Beautiful. And how many grams of protein, John, do you think is in a salad like this?
I don't know. But the thing is it actually, it's on my website. I calculate this out for people.
Okay.
But I didn't look it up. It's about per serving, and this makes about 6 servings, about 290 calories.
That's good. That's not a lot of calories. All right, well, I'm going to try this. And I like how you put the tuna salad in a little wrap. That
put it on the wrap.
Easy to eat.
Yeah, put it on a piece of bread, or you can eat it like I have it there, just with a celery stick or a cracker. So,
okay, that's good.
You like it?
I do. It tastes just like tuna.
You know, the dulce and the chickpeas definitely kind of like do the trick.
But it's tuna.
Tuna, yep.
John, thank you very much.
Thanks, Jerry.
Go plant-based when you can. It's healthier for you. Be right back with more Daytime right after this. This is good.